Hi there. On this video, we're just going to look at the Sharp 217 and how you can use the tabs or tables. So on your keyboard, you've got a couple of buttons down here. On the default template, it's called GLU, so Guest Lookup, and then NBAL, so New Balance. We often rename them as Open Tab and Hold Tab, just because it's just a bit clearer for people. So if you're serving food and adding items to a customer's table, and then they can continue to add to it and then pay up at the end, or similarly, you know, if you're just a bar and you know just want a tab for a customer, you can use the open tabs as a great way of handling that. So all you need to do is just need to type in the table number, or if you don't actually have true table numbers, you can just press open tab. And what you'll see on the screen is it'll say GLU and then number 10, so it's guest lookup 10, so table 10, and you can add items into it. And then when you finish at this moment, you just do the hold tab. So we've got receipt printing on, so it's just going to print off exactly what I've just added to that tab at that moment. So a customer goes away, comes back in a bit and says wants to add some more items to table 10. You just go 10 open tab, and you'll see the existing balance 2270. Add some more items, up to 35.95, and we'll just hold tab again. And again, the receipt that comes out is just for the items that I've just put through. If the customer then comes up and says, "Can I have my bill now?" So you would open up number 10. You actually just hold the tab, and then the GC receipt will actually give you a full bill of everything that's been added. So you've got your full breakdown of every single item and the grand total of each item that's been added up to it. So the total to pay is $35.95. So if a customer wants to now pay that tab, again, open up your number 10, and then you just use the corresponding payment as you would for any transaction. So if he was giving me £40 cash, I just go 4000 and then the cash button. I know that tab is back down to zero, and in theory you could now open up number 10 again, and we're actually back to a zero balance. So really that's as easy and as simple as to use the tabs. You can also get a report off to see what open tabs you've got in the system. Sometimes a little bit tricky to keep track of everything. So if you wanted to run a report, you use your mode button, go down to X1Z1, and in reading, there's an option down here called GLU menu. And you do have options by range or clerk or balance. It's probably easier just to go by range. And then again, you can go from and to, but generally most people won't have that many open. It's probably best to run the whole report. It's only going to print off the ones that are actually outstanding and owe money. So it's not this huge report of 9,999 tables. It is the only active ones. So we'll just run that off. And so what this report shows here is we've got tables 7, 8, and 9 all open with balances. So you see the balances on the right hand side. So table 7 is 6.95, 8 is 17.85, and so on. So like I say, it's just a report to show you what's open. So then we could open up number 7. So 7, open tab. If you can't see all the items, you want to print it off, again, you could do the whole tab, GC receipt, and you'll get a full breakdown of what's on that tab. And again, hopefully you can just get the customer to settle up. So that is very quickly how you can use the tabs, and useful for a lot of customers. Not everyone uses it, but it is a useful feature on this machine. Okay, thanks, bye.